Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. Today I'm talking about problem solving. We're going to be translating word problems into equations and then solving. The first one's not a word problem just so much as a something written that needs to be translated. A number subtracted from negative 10 is negative 20. So we have some number, I'm going to call it x, and we're subtracting it from negative 10. That means that negative 10 has to go first. And we're subtracting some number. I'll call it x. And that is like our verb, so it's an equal sign there, is negative 20. We're going to translate and solve these. So now that I've translated that, I have a number that's being subtracted from negative 10, and it equals negative 20. I'm going to solve that by adding 10 to both sides, because remember, I'm always trying to get my coefficient, my variable by itself. When I do that, notice that I have a minus sign in front of that x. I need to bring that down. These two additive inverses go away to 0. And negative 20 and positive 10, I have more negatives by 10. And then I have to do one more thing, and that is make my coefficient be positive 1. Since I have a negative there, even though I don't see it, it's like having a negative 1 there. So I'm going to divide both sides by negative 1. And what that's going to do is it's going to make this become positive x, because those two negatives will cancel out. And over here I have two negatives, which makes 10. So a number subtracted from negative 10 is negative 20. My number, I think, is 10. That 10 is being subtracted from negative 10, and sure enough, that equals negative 20. I don't know why I tried to write 12 there. Okay, that's the first one. Let's look at the next one. Again, we're translating. We have to know the terms product, sum, difference, quotient, because those are going to be used. The product of negative 4 and the difference of a number and 6 is 12. Well, the easy part that I want to go for right now is this. It is 12. That means that what we're going to write is going to be equal to 12. Do what you can and start filling in the pieces. The next thing I'm seeing here is that we have a product. What are we multiplying? We're multiplying negative 4 and a difference. Those are the two things that we're multiplying. So I want to say, I'm going to write my difference in a parentheses, and I'm going to multiply that times negative 4. Now I have to figure out, what am I subtracting? That's what a difference means, right? So I've got a product, which means multiply. So negative 4 times this difference is 12. And the difference is a number and 6. So let's call our number n here. There I go. So I have negative 4 being multiplied times that difference, which is a number and 6. And that equals 12 overall. To solve this, I'm going to distribute negative 4 times n is negative 4n. Now be careful, because negative 4 times negative 6, see how there's two negatives here? Two negatives make a positive. Yes, this is a subtraction sign, but a subtraction sign and a negative have the same, they have the same powers here when we multiply. It happens the same way, I've lost the word that I wanted to use, but they have the same effect when we multiply. So two negatives make a positive. 4 times 6 is 24, and that equals 12. Why do they have the same effect? Because n minus 16, or n minus 6, is the same as n plus negative 6. So if I have a subtraction, I know that it's going to have the same effect as a negative, because I could rewrite it as a negative. And you can see that if you had negative 4 times negative 6, you'd get that positive 24. Okay, now I want to subtract that 24 from both sides to get the variable term by itself. And that gives me negative 12. I have more negatives than positives. And then I want to get rid of the coefficient, which is negative 4. So I want to divide both sides by negative 4. And when you have a negative divided by a negative, they go away and you get n equals 3. All right, so n equals 3 is the answer. If they asked me to translate, I would give them this piece. If they asked me to solve, then I'd go ahead and do this piece. We're doing both translating and solving here. Okay, next one says the quotient of a number in 3 is equal to negative 5. A quotient is equal to negative 5. So I know that my equation equals negative 5, and it's a quotient, and a quotient is a division problem. So what am I going to divide? A number, whatever stated first, has to go on top. I'm going to call that A. And 3, the quotient of a number in 3 is negative 5. And now I'm going to solve that. Because I have something divided by 3, I'm going to multiply by 3. I'm going to call it 3 over 1 just so I can keep things straight. Over here, I'll just call it 3. 3 over 1 and 3 are the same. And now my 3's cancel, leaving A, and negative 5 times 3 is negative 15. The quotient of a number in 3 is equal to negative 5. Negative 15 divided by 3 does equal negative 5. All right, the next one, let me move this up a little. The product of a number in 6 is the same as 40 less 3 times that same number. And that wording to me is a little awkward, but I noticed on the homework assignment that I'm giving you, they have that. So I wanted to talk about what that means. You see how we have the is here? The is our equal sign. So everything before that is on the left, and everything after that is on the right of our equation. So what's on the left? The product of a number and 6. That product means multiply, and we're multiplying a number and 6. Because of the commutative property, it doesn't matter which one we put first. I'm going to put the 6 first and then that. Notice I'm using different variables, x, n, a, y, because I don't want you to think there's only one variable. And you can use whatever you want. You could use a smiley face. It wouldn't change anything. Okay, the second half, the same as 40 less, 3 times that same number. 40 less, it doesn't say 40 less than, it's just less. That means subtracted. 40 less than something means we have to have that something first. So we have 3 times that same number. That is, we're using the same variable. 3 times that same variable, 40 less than that would be that we're taking 40 away. Kind of awkward, huh? Anyway, I'm going to subtract 3y from both sides to get those common variables together. So we have 3y equals a minus 40. Don't forget about that negative sign. And then we have to get rid of the coefficient by dividing. And so here I'm going to get y equals, and I'm not going to change that. There's no way to reduce that. I'm just going to say it's negative 40/3. I'm not going to change it to a mixed number. I'm not going to change it to a decimal. I'm just going to leave it just like that. Okay, let's see the next one. Bill can run 3 times as fast as Lou. If their total speed is 20 miles per hour, find their speeds. So we need to do a little more work here, because suddenly we're talking about 2 people. And it's very useful to talk about what your variables are going to be. So I'm going to say that L equals Lou's speed. Why would I choose L to be Lou's speed and not B to be Bill's speed? Well, because Bill's speed is based on Lou. So Lou is what I call our base variable. So then we say, well, how can we describe Bill's speed? We don't want to call it B because we don't want 2 variables. We want 1. Bill is 3 times as fast as Lou. So we can say Bill is 3L. Okay? Now, don't you agree that Bill's speed plus Lou's speed equals 20? Because they said that to get their total speed. So all we have to do is replace Bill's speed with what his speed was, which was 3L, and Lou's speed with what hers was, which was L, and that's going to be 20. It's important because what happens is people a lot of times forget about putting that L and they do 3L. But it's 3L and L, Lou's speed and Bill's speed, that add up to 20. That gives us 4L is 20, and dividing by 4, we get L is 5. What does 5 mean? 5 is L, which we said L was going to be Lou's speed. So Lou's speed is 5 miles per hour. That's 12-minute mile. Not too great, but nothing to brag about. But Bill's speed is 3 times that. So his speed is 3 times 5, which is 15 miles per hour. Now we're getting pretty impressive, right? If he's doing 3-minute mile. So I don't know if that's very realistic, but that's what we have. He is 15 miles per hour. Okay, pretty nice for him. Okay, that's 4 miles. That's 4-minute miles. Yeah, I think that's possible. Okay, so there you go. We had to solve for one, then solve for the other, and then we have our two different answers. If you have that in the computer or you want to make sure you enter Lou's speed correctly and Bill's speed correctly and don't get them mixed up. Okay, Sydney has saved $12,500 more than Seth. If they have saved $61,750 together, how much have each of them saved? Okay. So I'm going to say Sydney and Seth have the same first letter. It doesn't help anything, does it? I'm going to say X equals, now Sydney has saved more than Seth. So Seth is our base variable here. X equals the dollars that Seth has saved. What's Sydney then? Well, Sydney saved $12,500 more. She saved the same amount plus $12,500 more. That's the dollars that Sydney saved. She's a better saver, or she started earlier or something. Now, they saved $61,750 together. So if we take everything Seth saved and everything that Sydney saved and add them together, we get $61,750. You agree with that? This is what Seth saved, X, and this is what Sydney saved, X plus $1,250. $12,500. Okay, so then if I add together my x's, x plus x is 2x, and then I'm going to get rid of the $12,500. And I have 2x left over here, and I'm going to subtract on my calculator $61,750 minus $12,500. Then I have $49,250. $49,250. Now I'm going to divide both sides by 2 because I'm trying to get rid of that coefficient. And x equals half of that, $24,625. They both have done pretty well with their savings. But what does x mean? Well, x, we said, was going to be what Seth saved. So I know that Seth saved $24,625. How much did Sydney save? Well, Sydney saved $24,625 plus $12,500 more, right? So I add those two together to figure out what she saved. She saved $37,125. And that is setting up a problem. These last two are tricky, and these are going to come up. So you have to get used to setting up a problem with two unknowns, but using one variable. We don't want two different variables in there. All right, have a fantastic day.